So just take that and substitute. So you have all the 10 equations for 10 unknowns. That's all you have to do. Then we are ready to write the pseudocode. So how does it go? Let's see. Step 1. So it start. Step 2. Define 2 vectors or arrays. We will call them t new and t old. T new equal to zeros 10, t old equal to zeros 10 comma 1, 10 rows 1 column, so it's a column vector. Okay, so this is what will contain tn plus 1 and tn. So then initialize, that is use initial condition. It says t old I, so let's write it properly. So for I equal to 1 to 10, t old I must be set to initial temperature distribution, which is 25. That was easy, right? So that's the initial condition. Then the next thing is initialize time and delta t and so on. So I'm going to put t equal to 0. This is the start time. I'm going to pick a value for delta t. I'm going to pick delta t equal to 0.01. This you have to experiment with. And then we know that delta x equal to 1 over 9. Okay. And we are given, and we need this number, lambda equal to delta t times 3 divided by 1 over 9 whole squared. Remember what this is? This is actually our delta t k over x squared, delta x whole squared. It's a convenient short form and you can do that. In fact, you may want to take a smaller value. I'm going to take 0.001 because this 1 over 9 may give us some trouble. So lambda, I'm going to put it like that. So this is a convenient shorthand so that we don't go on calculating everything. So now we are ready. So now what we are going to do is for, so we are now going to say set t max equal to 10. So that's a long time. We are going to do a simulation for a long time. So then we are going to say for, so now while t less than t max, put t equals t plus delta t. This is update time. You moved it by 1. So that's very good. Then I'm going to do, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to plot. So display old. I'm going to show what it looks like so that I know. So we're going to show this thing, and then we are going to say, so now start by saying t new 1. We know the first value because our boundary condition says if you go all the way, can you see? There it is, 25 plus 0.3 t. So we go up here, equal to 25 plus 0.3 t. That was easy, right? Then we do for I equal to 2 to n minus 1 t nu I equals lambda times t, what was that? T old I plus 1 plus t old I minus 1 minus 2 times t old I plus g, what was our function? 4 times something, right? So let me erase that, and I always keep writing g, so that's not what I want. I want 4 times 4 delta t times x minus 4. X is for I, x is actually we calculated it here. X is xi is I minus 1 times 1 over 9. Can you see that? So it is I minus 1 over delta x. So let us put delta x here. Delta x equal to 1 over 9 is the other thing that we want to put. So 4t I minus 1 over delta x plus 1 times t old I minus 30. That's my differential equation. So please pay attention. This is xi. Okay, so now I got my differential equation. Now the last boundary condition. So t nu at n equals, let us see, make sure we write that down with this mess, equal to t nu t old at n plus lambda times. So I got to replace t11 by 4 times 2 over 9, so that's 8 over 9 plus t9 plus t old 9 plus t old 9 minus 2 times t old 10. This is actually nothing but t old 11 calculated from heat transfer boundary condition, heat flux boundary condition. That's how we did. Then we are done. Then, so after we do all of this, we just put t old equal to t new. That means I'm going to replace this with that and then continue to the next one. So let's make sure we understand. So what did I do? Oh, I already initialized that. So I don't need this. So let's make through. I start out, I set out the two arrays, t old and t new. I initialize using the initial condition, that's here. So I use that to set what is t old. This is I initial condition. Then I set all the values, start time, delta t, delta x, everything is there. And this is a convenient shorthand for us. And then we set the simulation time. Then we do while t is less than t max, t equal to t plus delta t, update the time, display the old thing, calculate, this is boundary condition, then do the differential equation, then do the other boundary condition, and then update. Notice that every time it goes through the while loop, it will do two things. It will change the time, it will display the old value. So every time it will do it. That's how it works. Okay. Next time I will implement this in MATLAB and show you the answer.